Wow, good morning, and this is Dialogue Box. You're welcome, and we've been very, very excited having you on board and having everyone who are, we've been having lots of comments and several opinions that have been shared, and the views are increasing by the day. We are really thankful to you for all that you have done to help us and make our voice even stronger, because we know, like we have always said, that each and every one of us, we have a role to play in nation building, and that is why we are all set out to make a difference in our world. This morning we are giving more attention to what we talked about yesterday, talking about yesterday we looked at the leadership challenge that has kind of engulfed Nigeria, because we've had cases where transition from one government to the other has always been a major issue. And we have seen that replaying itself in the All Progressives Congress, where a chairman was suspended and the court corroborated the suspension. And to get an acting chairman in his stead has been a major challenge. You know, several people laying claim to that office, and we said, no, this should not be so. So our analyst yesterday, Barrister Prince Olomuzemi Agbodo, told us that the major aspect that Nigeria has to give more attention to is the fact that our political parties have to be based on ideology, not just personalities. And when a personality moves, it's like a fan club. Everybody moves with him or her. No, it shouldn't be so. So as much as we can, our political parties should be based on ideology. And he also talked about the fact that the constitution has to be given a major attention. When parties don't have a strong constitution, you see cases where anything is obtainable and anything goes. And that is why you see lots of stories of decamping and defecting from one political party to the other. And he said if that is given adequate attention to, in addition to some other points he made, you will be sure that Nigeria's leadership system will far be better than what is obtainable right now. So in case you missed yesterday's edition, you can visit our page. It's on our Facebook page. Then we have it on our website, www.blossomnigeria.com. And also, you can also visit YouTube to watch it and get even your, we can also get your opinion and your reaction. So today is a follow-up to what we did yesterday. We are addressing the leadership challenge, but we are looking at it from the angle of the political system, because they are all a fallout of the leadership system, leadership challenge we are talking about. So a lot of times we have cases where court orders are given, counter court orders will come, and we have a way of making it look as if it's court versus court. So what actually is the case? So we are addressing court orders and counter orders in the political system in Nigeria. I say it again, addressing court orders and counter orders in the political system in Nigeria. So we will just give you a brief background and we will discuss from there. So we look forward to having your opinions and your comments. We have it here that the current political crisis in Nigeria have assumed a different dimension with the spate of court cases, ongoing litigations and court injunctions that have flooded the political scene. There have been court rulings and counter-court rulings complicating the political landscape. The question is, are the courts following the right pattern to improve the political system in Nigeria, or are they becoming weapons of political warfare in the hands of politicians? So these are some of the areas we need to look at. Why is it that a high court, let's assume in Benin, we give an injunction, and another high court in Port Harcourt, we give a counter injunction. So what is happening? So it's like, if we are to use a more academic term, we are saying legal perspectives to some of these challenges. So we'd like to hear your opinion. And don't forget that we've been having some of these cases unfolding. So we'll just give you a brief insight into some of the cases we're talking about. And you can now give us what you think should be the way forward. First of all, the Independent National Electoral Commission, INEC, in their meeting yesterday, that's Tuesday, June 23, or June 23rd, in preparation for some upcoming elections in parts of the country, stated that they are concerned about increasing court injunctions, saying that political parties should note that the conduct of elections are complex and involve extensive planning. Any disruption of these processes come at a huge cost to the nation. So they therefore stated that the spate of pre-election litigations and conflicting orders can harm the smooth conduct of primaries and upcoming elections across the country. So some instances of some of these court cases include, these are extra research we did to give you some of these court cases like we earlier stated. We have one, the release of the spokesman of the Coalition of United Political Parties of Nigeria, CUPP, Ikenga Ugochinyere, based on a court order. First of all, he was arrested for some allegations that he made some comments about some senators and the rest, and now a court order has given his release. Then we have another one, Tony Ayegbemi, the state chairman of Edo State People's Democratic Party, PDP, has stated that the governorship primaries will hold despite different lawsuits. That means, irrespective of ongoing lawsuits about the governorship primaries in the People's Democratic Party, PDP, the state chairman is insisting that the primaries will still hold. Then we also have another one where Chief Victor Giadom, who had declared himself as the APC national chairman following the ruling of the Court of Appeal, which affirmed Adams Oshomole's suspension from the same position, that although a high court of the Federal Capital Territory, FCT, reaffirmed Giadom's position, another high court in Rivers State restrained him from parading himself as such. So what do we have here? Conflicting court orders. Then we have another court ruling again. An update on the issue is that another court order authorized Chief Victor Giadom, and he has called for a neck meeting because they authorized him to still be the acting national chairman of APC. So he went ahead, sent out a ruling yesterday, and he said, I, Chief Victor Giadom, having been duly authorized by court order to act as national chairman of our great party and to preside over all meetings of the NWC and NEC as the National Working Committee and the National Executive Commission, hereby and with the consent of the president, he said, has reconvened a neck meeting that was earlier billed to hold on the 17th of March 2020. So now he is saying that based on the fact that a court ruling has given him the go-ahead to still be the acting national chairman, so he is calling for a neck meeting. So you can see a lot of conflicting orders. Then we have another one. In another instance, a federal high court sitting in Port Harcourt, Rivers State, had on Monday issued an order stopping the Edo State Governor Godwin Obaseki from contesting in the PDP primaries. And this is the same governor that just decamped from APC to PDP. And the next thing we are hearing is that a court order has stopped him from contesting in the primaries. Then, as a follow-up, a counter-court injunction came from the High Court of Justice in Ekpoma, that's the Judicial Division, and restrained the People's Democratic Party, the Independent National Electoral Commission, INEC, and others from removing, preventing, or purporting to exclude the Edo State Governor, Mr. Godwin Obaseki, or any other aspirant who has been cleared by the party from participating in the gubernatorial primaries slated for 25th June. So like I said earlier, this is another counter court order from the same high court. One was from Port Harcourt, the other one, this one is from Ekpoma in Edo State. So then we still have the River State governor who is also complaining that his own party, the PDP, the People's Democratic Party, as Yunsom Wike, has described some members of the party as tax collectors. And he said they are able to carry out some of these actions because an order was obtained from a federal high court in Port Harcourt backing some of their actions. So you wonder, what exactly is the issue? Then, with all these and many more cases, the question is, how do we strike a balance? Talking about addressing the political system in Nigeria. So we are talking about giving all we have to stabilizing the political scene, the political system, and ensuring that the leadership in Nigeria is free from, we call them external interest. So we'll still have our barrister, Prince Uzemi Olomuagbodo, that will talk with us this morning. And we also want you to send in your comments, your thoughts, and let's talk so that we can know how to prevent some of these current challenges that has engulfed the political scene in Nigeria. What is your take when we have a situation where there are court orders from a high court, or there is a court order from a high court, and maybe even if the other party is not satisfied, rather than going to an appeal court, you still have a counter order from another high court saying that what this other court gave a ruling for is not, they don't support it. So because of that, they knock it off, and this other one comes up with a counter injunction. Is this supposed to be so? So whatever you think, you can write your thoughts, your opinions, and your comments. And don't forget, we are talking about having to address some of these challenges. And we have always said that we are not just talking to criticize, but we are working towards having solutions. What are the solutions you propose? Like after our discussion yesterday, we were able to come up with the fact that most of our parties should work on having stronger constitutions and a strong ideology that they are built on, not just on personalities or other interests. So whatever you think should be the way forward, you send us your thoughts and your comments. And once we have Barrister Prince Olomuagbodo on the line, we can also get his comments on this. That's his live comment from our in-house analyst. What is your thought? What is your opinion? And what do you think should be the way forward? I can see some of us watching and waving, but as you are waving, also give us your comments in line with your waving so that we can work out a solution for this current political crisis that has kind of engulfed the scene in Nigeria. All right, we have a comment here from, just a second. He said, from Francis Chukwu, he's saying, why are we having too many court rulings on the same case? That is the same question we are asking right now. So maybe hearing from a lawyer will give us some insight into this. Is it legal? Is it accepted? And why do we have a situation where several rulings are coming on the same case? So is it about whose ruling is more influential? Or because that's why even the INEC had to complain. They said they can't really understand it, because it's like you are arranged for a primary election, and the next day you hear that a court order has nullified it, and they try to arrange another one, another court order comes. So they are wondering, and they are saying that to organize elections, in quotes, they are not easy. It's a lot of work. So if they are to do a thorough job as they are expected to do, then sufficient room should be given to them, not court injunctions, counter court injunctions, court orders, counter court orders. At the end of the day, even they themselves are confused. They don't know how to go about it. So where are our courts? What are they doing? Are they helping the system, or they have, like we stated, become political tools in the hands of politicians, which should never be the case? So give us your thoughts, give us your opinions, and let's hear from you. All right, we have from our Barrister Prince. He has greeted us. Good morning. Good morning, Barrister Prince. Do we have you now? Are you online? Okay, trying to connect. Okay, once you connect, or once he connects, we can take his comment or his opinion. All right, we have another wonderful analyst here, Grace Emmanuel. She says, good morning, Blossom Nigeria. The whole confusion boils down to corruption, greed, and I really don't know. I look forward to hearing the legal advice. So she is saying, or she's attributing it to corruption, greed, and she thinks that is it has really become like a confusion. So she's looking forward to getting a legal advice. Good morning, Grace Emmanuel. Thank you so much for that. We appreciate that. While we are trying to get our analysts to connect, we also get you to send in your comment immediately. Let's know what you think and what should be the way forward. And like Grace Emmanuel has said, she looks forward to hearing the legal advice. So everything has a solution. Every problem has a solution. All right, let's go.